Welcome to the next session of geometric progression. We are in the process of doing the problems of GP. Let's see the next question, sir. The second term of a GP. Is 24. The second term of a GP is 24, and the fifth term is 81. The sequence is
1 to write the sequence, what is required? First term value is required and common ratio value is required. Again, I am repeating, to write the sequence, first term and common ratio values are required. Given
T2, AR is equal to 24, T5, A into R to the power of 4 is 81. Equation number 2, AR to the power of 4 divided by AR, 81 divided by 24, AR, this A and A cancel, R will go 3 times, R to the power of 3, 3 will go 27 times, 3 will go 8 times, 3 cube by 2 cube, 3 by 2 whole power 3, 3 by 2 whole power 3. Here is equal to sign we have, powers are equal, so we can equate the bases, R is equal to 3 by 2, common ratio value is obtained, AR is equal to 24, A into 3 by 2 is equal to 24, A is equal to 24 into 2 by 3, 3 will go 8 times 16, A is equal to 16. Sequence is A, AR, AR square, AR cube, etc. A means 16, AR means 16 into 3 by 2, 16 into 9 by 4, etc. 2 will go 8 times, 16, 8 threes are 24, 9 fours are 36, etc. This is the sequence. Look at the next question. The sum of three numbers in GP is 39 and their product is 729. The numbers are 3, 27, 9, option B 9, 3, 27, option C 3, 9, 27, option D, none of this. Okay. Now, three terms in a geometric progression are required for us. See the solution. Let t1 comma t2 comma t3 be the three terms. Divided by first term is equal to third term divided by second term. Second condition, S is equal to T1 plus T2 plus T3, this is 39. Third one, product T1 into T2 into T3. T3 by T2. 9 divided by 27, 1 by 3. T2 by T1 is not equal to T3 by T2. So option A is not my answer. Let's go for option B. T2 by T1 is equal to 3 by 9. This is 1 by 3. T3 by T2 is equal to 27 by 3, this is 9. T2 by T1 is not equal to T3 by T2. Option B is not the answer. Option C. 3, 9, 27. T2 by T1 is equal to 9 by 3, this is 3. T3 by T2 is equal to 27 by 9, this is 3. 27 divided by 9, this is 3. Common ratio is same. So first condition is satisfied. First condition is satisfied. Let us go with second one. Sum is equal to T1 plus T2 plus T3. This is equal to 3 plus 9 plus 27, 39. 27 plus 3 is 30, 30 plus 9 is 39. Product T1 into T2 into T3. 3 into 9 into 27. 27 into 27, 729. So option C satisfied all the conditions. Option C satisfied all the conditions. Therefore, C is the answer to the given question. Okay. Next question. In a geometric progression, the product of first three terms is 27 by 8. The middle term is 8, AR, AR square, etc. be the geometric progression. Now what is given? Product of first three terms. A into AR into AR square is equal to 27 by 8. A cube into R cube is 3 cube by 2 cube. Here also you can write AR whole power 3. because left hand side is of the type a power x into b power x, which can be written as ab whole power x. Right hand side is of the type a power x by b power x, a by b whole power x. This is equal to 3 by 2 whole power 3. Powers are equal is equal to sign, bases can be equated. Now, what is the middle term? AR. So, AR is equal to 3 by 2. Next question, if you save 1 paisa today, comma 2 paisa next day, four paisa the succeeding day, and so on. That your total savings in 2 weeks will be 1 paisa today, so first term is 1, 2 paisa next day, 2 is the second term, 4 paisa the succeeding day means third term is 4, etc. Common ratio 2 by 1 is equal to 4 by 2 is equal to 2. 2 by 1 is equal to 4 by 2 is equal to 2. And n is equal to 14. S is equal to a into r power n minus 1 by r minus 1. A is equal to 2. Common ratio is 2 power 14 minus 1 by 2 minus 1. 2 power 14 minus 1 into 14. So 16, 384. 16, 384 minus 1. 16383 paise. This is equal to rupees 163.83. Paisa converted into rupees. So this is 163.8. Look at the next question. Sum of n terms of the series. Up to n terms. Now option A, Sn is equal to 4 by 9 into 10 by 9 into 10 power n minus 1 minus. Option B, Sn is equal to 10 by 9 10 power n minus 1 minus n. Option C, Sn is equal to 4 by 9 into 10 power n minus 1 minus. Option D, none. For these type of problems, no need to solve. Look at this, similar type of problems we solved in arithmetic progression also. That same point I am repeating once again. When the sequence is having only one term, when the sequence is having only one term, then S1 is equal to T1. When the sequence is having two terms, S2 is equal to T1 plus T2. When the sequence is having three terms, S3 is equal to T1 plus T2 plus T3, etc. This way it is going on. So put n is equal to, sorry, before this, you take T1, T1 is equal to 4, put n is equal to 1. In option A, S1 is equal to 4 by 9, 10 by 9 into 10 minus 1 minus 1. It will go, so this is 4 by 9 into 10 minus 1. Again cancel, this is 4. T1 is equal to S1, option A is the answer. You can verify this S2 also. T1 plus T2 is equal to S2 condition. So T1 plus T2, 4 plus 44, 48. S2 is equal to 4 by 9, 10 by 9 into 10 square, 100 minus 1, minus 2. Minus 1 means 99 minus 2. It will go 11 times. 110 minus 2. 4 by 9 into 108, 9 ones are 9, 9 twos. So this is equal to 4 twos are 8, 4 ones are 4. T1 plus T2 is equal to S2. Here, for your clarity purpose, two values I verified. But when you are doing the same problem in the exam, no need to verify two values. This is simple. Time saving option. Put n is equal to 1. Put n is equal to 1. And verify. If T1 is equal to S1, then option A is the answer. Otherwise, move to option B. Again, put n equal to 1. If T1 is equal to S1, that is the answer. Otherwise, you have to move option C. This way. Yes, it being the first problem here in geometric progression. So, with the two values I verified, so that you will get confidence. Anyway, option A is my answer. But next time onwards, whenever I face this type of problem, whenever I have this type of problem, I will check up T1 equal to S1 only. Okay? Next one, sum of n terms of the series zero point 1, except ऑप्शन ए एस एन इज इक्वल टू 1/9 विद इन द ब्रैकेट्स एन माइनस 1 - 0.1 होल पावर एन. ऑप्शन बी एस एन इज इक्वल टू 1/9 एन माइनस 1 - 0.1 होल पावर एन. By 9. Option C, SN is equal to N minus 1 minus 0.1 whole power N by 9. Option D, none. These are my options. Now first you take T1 from the given question. This is 0.1, T1 0.1. Now in the options you put N equal to 1. Put N is equal to 1. So option A, S1 is equal to 1/9, 1 minus 1 minus 0.1 is 0.9. This is 1 - 0.9 is 0.1. One minus point one, point nine, divided by 9.01. Let me check up the question. N minus 1 - 0.1 whole power n. So here it is, LHS is not equal to RHS. Let us go to option B, S1 is equal to 1/9, 1 - 0.1/9, 1 - 0.9/9, 1/9. This is 0.9 divided by 9, 0.1, 1 minus 0.1, 0.9, 0.9, 0.9 divided by 9, 0.1. So S1 is equal to T1, S1 is equal to T1, option B is the answer to the given question. Option B is the answer to the given question. Okay, let's see the next question. The sum of first 20 terms of a GP is 244 times the sum of first 10 terms. The common ratio is What is given? S20 is equal to 244 into S10. Except this, no other information is provided. Now most of you will get a confusion, which formula should I use here? Again, I am repeating this point. What is given in the question? This relation. S20 is equal to 244 into S10. Except this, no other information is provided. So, there are two formulas for SN. Which one should I use here? You can use any one. That doesn't make any difference. So, I am taking S is equal to A into R power N minus 1 by R minus 1. S20 is equal to A into R power 20 minus 1 by R minus 1. So S20 and S10 values are this one. Just n is replaced with the 20 first, then n is replaced with the 10. Now S20 is equal to 244 into S10. A into R power 20 minus 1 by R minus 1 is equal to 244 into A into R minus 1, R minus 1 cancel, AA cancel. This can be written as R power 10 into 2 minus 1 is equal to 244 into R power 10 minus 1. A power xy can be written as A power x whole power y. A power xy can be written as A power x whole power y. So this is R power 10 whole square minus 1 square. 1 to the power any number is 1 only. 244 into R to the power of 10 minus 1. A square minus B square can be written as A minus B into A plus B. R power 10 minus 1 into R power 10 plus 1. Cancel. 244. 244 minus 1, 243. R to the power of 10 is R to the power of, 3 to the power of 5. Here, neither bases are equal nor powers are equal. So, you don't get the answer. To get the answer, what is required? Either bases must be same or powers must be same. What will I do here? This 3 can be written as root 3 whole square to the power 5. So square root of 3 whole power 10. R to the power of 10 is R root 3 to the power 10. Now powers are equal. Is equal to sign I have. I can equate the bases. Notice one more point here. Power is an even number. Power is even number. So whether the base is plus root 3, whether the base is plus root 3 or minus root 3, in both the cases, this equality sign is true. Therefore, R is equal to plus or minus root 3. R is equal to plus or minus root 3. Okay. Next, the sum of the series plus 3 plus 9 plus 27 plus etc is 364. The number of terms is okay sir, A is equal to 1 first term, common ratio, second term divided by first term, 3 by 1, 3, 9 by 3, 3, 27 by 9, 3, common ratio is same, that is 3. S is equal to 364, N is equal to question mark. S is 364, N is equal to question mark. Common ratio is greater than 1. So this is the formula I can use. 364 is equal to A means 1, 3 power N minus 1 by 3 minus 1. So when I cross multiply, 364 into 2, it will become 8, 6 2s are 12, 3 2s are 6, 7 28, 3 power n minus 1. Take minus 1 also to the left hand side, 7 29 is equal to 3 power n. Can we write 7 29 as some power of 3? Definitely we can write. 3 power 6 is equal to 3 power n. 3 when multiplied 6 times you will get 729. Bases are equal, powers can be equated, n is equal to 6. As the answer. Next question. The product of three numbers in GP is 729 and the sum of their squares is 890. The numbers are option A 9 comma 3 comma 27, look at this sir. Here options are numerical numbers. Whenever options are numerical numbers, we can verify the given conditions through options. T1 comma T2 comma T3 be the three terms in a GP. Let us take first condition they have to satisfy is common ratio, second term divided by first term should be equal to third term divided by second term. Next, second condition is T1 into T2 into T3. This is 729. Third condition, sum of their squares is equal to 819. These are the three conditions my options has to satisfy. So the option which satisfies these three is the answer. Let us see option A. 3 by 9 is not equal to 27 by 3. Option A is the wrong answer. Option B. 3 by 27 is not equal to 9 by 3. Option B is not the answer. Option C. 9 by 3 is equal to 27 by 9 is equal to 3. 9 by 3 is equal to 27 by 9 is equal to 3. Next product, first condition is satisfied. 3 into 7 into 27. 729. Second condition also satisfied. Third condition, 3 square 9 square plus 27 square. 3 3s are 9, 9 9s are 81. 27 into 27. 27 into is equal to 729. 729 plus 81 plus 9, 890. So option C satisfied all the conditions. Option C satisfied all the conditions here. Therefore, option C is the answer to the given question. Okay, next question. The number of terms to be taken. The number of terms to be taken so that one plus two plus four plus eight plus etc. will be 8191. Okay, now look at this, sir. A is equal to 1, R is equal to 2. Second term divided by first term is equal to third term divided by second term is equal to fourth term divided by third term. This ratio is same, 2. S is equal to 8191, N is equal to question mark. So S is equal to A into R power N minus 1 by R minus 1. Take minus 1 to this side. 8192 is equal to 2 power N. So this is 2 into raise the power of 2 till you will get 8192. Let us verify. Can I get that value or not? So 2 power 13 is 8192. 2 power 13 is equal to 2 power n. N is equal to 13. okay. Let us move to the questions of additional question bank. A cubic. Question number 94. The third term of a GP is the square of first and fifth term is 64. The series is option A 4 plus 8 plus 16 plus 32 plus etc. Option B 4 minus 8 plus 16 minus 32 plus minus etc. Option C both. Option D none. Here both means both A and B. See the solution part of this. What is given in the question? T3 is equal to T1 square and T5 is equal to 64. And T5 is equal to 64. Okay. Now I can verify these two conditions through options. T3 is equal to 16. It can be written as 4 square. 4 is nothing but T1. T3 is equal to T1 square. First condition is satisfied. T5 is equal to, I have to verify, before that let me check up the common ratio, sir. R is equal to 8 by 4, 16 by 8, 32 by 16 is equal to 2, common ratio is 2. T4 is equal to 32, in a geometric progression, succeeding term is equal to preceding term into common ratio. In a geometric progression, succeeding term is equal to preceding term into common ratio. So T5 is equal to T4 into common ratio. T4 is 32 into 2, 64. Option A has satisfied all the conditions given in the problem. Okay. Now both option is there. So let me check up option B also. 4 minus 8 plus 16 minus 32 plus minus etc. Common ratio minus 8 by 4, 16 by minus 8. Is equal to minus 2. Common ratio is same. So the sequence is in geometric progression. T3 is equal to 16. This is 4 square. 4 is nothing but T1 square. Third term of a GP is equal to square of the first term. So this condition also satisfied. Now T5 is equal to T4 into common ratio. Minus 32 into minus 2, this is 16. Given in the question, T5 is equal to 64. So option B also satisfied all the conditions given in the question. All the conditions given in the question. Option A as well as option B, both are answers to the given question. Option A as well as option B, both are answers to the given question. So option C is the right choice for us. So you have to select option C. Okay. Now let us see question number 95. Question number 95. Three numbers. Whose sum is 15? Are in AP. If 1, 4, 19 are added to them respectively, they are in GP. The numbers are. Option A 2, 5, 8. Option B 26, 5, -60. Option C both. Option D none. Now sir, see the conditions. T1, T2, T3 be the three numbers. Be the three numbers. What is the first condition they have to satisfy? They are in AP. So T2 minus T1 is. T1 plus T2 plus T3, this is 15. Third condition, T1 plus 1, T2 plus 4, T3 plus 19 are in GP. These are the three conditions the numbers has to satisfy. So the option which satisfies these three conditions is the answer. Let us see option A. 5 minus 2 is 8 minus 5, this is 3. First condition satisfied. Second condition, 2 plus 5 plus 8 15, second one also satisfied. Third one, 2 plus 1 5 plus 4 8 plus 19, 3, 9, 27 are in GP. Verify common ratio. 9 by 3 is equal to 27 by 9 is equal to 3. Therefore, option A is the answer at this stage. Let us check up option B also. 5 minus 26 is minus 21. Minus 16 minus 5 is minus 21. For option B also, common difference is same. First condition it also satisfied. S is equal to 26 plus 5 minus 16, 31 minus 16 is 15. Here also second condition satisfied. 26 plus 1, 5 plus 4 minus 16 plus 19, 27, 9, 3, these are in geometric progression. Look at the common ratio. 9/27 is equal to 3/9 is equal to 1/3. 9/27 is equal to 3/9 is equal to 1/3. So option B also satisfied all the conditions given in the question. So for this question also, both is the answer. In means option C is the answer to the given question. Okay. That's all in this, remaining in the next session. Thank you.